Whites. Save your breath, I'm going. Home to Prout? Shall I organise a car for you? To hell with your car! Sir Giles stormed out of his office and out of the building. Tents had begun to sprout on the banks of Gertie's Plash. Five archaeology, engineering and history undergrads from the University at Uttercombe had come at Dr. Pantridge's request, and the remaining 10 would be arriving on Sunday when the dig commenced. Their spokesperson was a ruddy-faced postdoctoral research fellow called Dougie Fancy. "There's a wee bit of concern about these protesters," he said. "How many did you reckon there were?" "No more than 6," said Arthur. "There are more of us than them, and they're pretty poor specimens, to be honest. We'll be fine." "The facilities are a bit basic at the moment," added Partridge. "We only have the one toilet, but we have 2 more being delivered on Sunday when you were originally scheduled to arrive. There's a sink in the cabin for washing, or there's the river, I suppose." "Aye, well, it's better than we get at most festivals," said Fancy. "It's a very odd price. I doubt we stock anything that retails for £18.66. Are you sure it came from us?" Shunter produced the price label that he'd found near the spot where Phoebe Kingshaw had been killed. "It's written on one of your stickers, and it looks reasonably new." The manager of Crute's department store concurred. "And handwritten too, which is unusual, as we normally use a pricing gun. I wonder if it was a sale item, shop soiled or something like that." "Is there any way to find out?" "Not without going back through the accounts," said the manager, "which, with all due respect, would take a great deal of time and effort. I couldn't authorise that unless it was for something like a police investigation. It's not, is it?"